Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about all the new announcements regarding permissions that came up along with Winter 24 release. So without any further delay, let's find it out. So the first one that I'll be talking about, with Winter 24, it will be much easier for you to understand what are the different things that are being enabled in the permission set. So let's see that in our Winter 24 org. So here I am in a Winter 24 org, and now if you go to a permission set from your setup menu and open any permission set, you'll find a new option which is basically view summary beta. Clicking on that, it will give you a summary of what is being enabled. For example, what are the different permission set groups that this permission set is being added? What are the different user permissions, object level permission? This is very helpful. From one single view, you'll find the object level permission for all the objects that are being enabled inside this permission set. Also, it will give you the field level permission. So I think this feature is really helpful. This feature is going to give you a consolidated view of everything what is happening inside this permission set. Okay, with that, let's move to the next one. Now let's imagine somebody came to your desk and asked, I need a report where I want to see all the permission set or permission set group is being assigned to the users, right? Before Winter 24, it was very difficult or almost impossible to achieve. But now after Winter 24, you can basically create a custom report type and use that report type to create a report which will show you the permission set and permission set group assignments to all the users. So let's see that in an action. Now here I am again in my Winter 24 org. So if you go to a section called report type, you can create a report type, and in the primary object, you can select permission set assignments and let's give a name as permission set user assignment and store in a category of other for the time being. And put it deployed, click on next, give it a name as permission set assignment, so click on next. Okay, so here click on save. Now your custom report type is ready. Now if you go to a report and try to create a report where you select the report type as permission set user assignment and start report. Here you can select all the things. What is the permission set name? What is the user full name? And what is the permission set API name? Just do a refresh and it's telling that these are the permission sets I have. I have a developer org, so I don't have much permission sets, but you can see these are the permission sets and these are the users that are being assigned to this permission set. So I think this is a very helpful feature, and this feature is going to help a lot of admin to create a report and understand the utilization of their permission sets inside the org. Okay, with that, let's move to the next one. Okay, so next one that I'm going to talk about, how you can select all fields when configuring the field permission. It may sound very minor, but trust me, when you are dealing with an object where there are a lot of fields and you want to select all the fields, instead of selecting one by one, it's much easier if there was a select all option. Winter 24 brings that select all option. Let's see that. So I'm inside the org. So if I go to my permission set and select any permission, let's say hello world, and now I want to go to the object settings and select any object. For example, I want to select accounts and I want to select all the fields. Currently, if you see, there are so many fields inside account object, but not all fields are selected, right? So if I click on edit now, this Winter 24 is giving me an option to select all. Clicking on that, it will select all. Clicking on that, it will select all. So it was not there before. Previously, you need to select individually, but with this select all option, it becomes life much easier. Now you can select everything and give permission to all of them. Okay, with that, let's move to the next one. So the next feature that I'm going to talk about is called Troubleshoot Permission Set Group Errors. So permission set group is actually a collection of permission sets. So when you add a permission set or remove a permission set from a permission set group, sometimes there is an error because the recalculation probably not happened or some kind of problem happened, right? You don't know. So in that case, how you can force initiate another recalculation, that's what this feature is all about. So every time you see there is an error on the permission set group, you will find that inside that permission set group at the very top, there will be a recalculate button. Clicking on that button, you have the power to initiate a recalculation of your entire permission set, permissions. With that, let's move to the next one. Okay, so this is another important thing. So I've seen in my career that there are projects where they have multiple objects with the same name, even within the same object, they have multiple fields with the same name. But the important factor is that even though they have the same name object or same name field, the API name cannot be the same. API name has to be unique. So API names are always different. Now, the problem that we faced, like while selecting those objects or the fields inside a permission set, we don't know which object or which custom field that we are choosing because they have the same name, right? Now with Winter 24, along with the object name, you will get the API name. Since API names are unique, so it will become very easy for you to select the correct object or correct field that you want to add or remove from the permission set. So let's see that in action. So if you go to any permission set, for example, this Hello World, and if you want to select an object for this permission set, what you will see, not only the object name, you will find the API name. Even inside the object, you will find the field name and the field API name. So imagine you have two fields with the same name customer priority. So that will appear here, but those two fields will definitely have different API name. So by API name, you can identify which field you want to be added in this permission set or you want to remove from this permission set. So this small feature is going to help a lot of admin. Okay, so with that, let's move to the next one. So what this feature is telling, how can I know how many permission set groups this permission set is added to? So I want to understand, is this permission set is being assigned to one group, zero groups, or maybe three or four groups? How can I know that? So that's something that is coming up with Winter 24 release. So let's see that in action. So here I am in the permission set section. So if you open the Hello World permission, so here, if you see at the very top page, you will see this permission set groups added to equals to one. So it means this permission set is being added to one permission set group. Now question is which permission set group? To understand that, click on View Summary Beta and it will tell you this Hello World is being added to Hello World Test permission set group. So this is a very powerful feature because it will tell you which are the defined permission set group this permission set is being added. Similar way, if I choose one other permission like buyer manager, you'll find it's not being added to any permission set group. So the count is zero. So at the very top page, you'll find the number of permission set groups that this permission set is being added. Clicking on View Summary will give you all the list of permission set groups where this is being added. So this is definitely a game changer. This is definitely going to help a lot of admins. Okay, with that, let's move to the next one. Okay, the next one that I'm going to talk about is basically a user access policy. I've already published a video about this user access policy. So if you haven't checked that out, please go and check that out. I'll put the link in the description as well as the top right corner. So please go and check that out. It came up, I think, in the last release. But what is happening in this release is getting improved. So now you can reference a total of three permission sets, permission set groups, or manage package licenses inside your user access policy filter. So I'm going to give you a very quick demo on that. So let's see that in a Winter 24 org. So here I am in my Winter 24 org. So the first thing that you need to do, you need to enable this feature. For that, search for user management settings. And inside this user management settings, you will find an option like user access policies beta. It will be disabled for you by default, but make it enabled. So once it's enabled, you will find an option called user access policies. Click on that and then here you can create your user access policies. So I'm going to create a very basic user access policy. Click on new and let's give it a name as test policy So what is trigger type and what is status? I have published a full dedicated video on this topic. Again, please go and check that out. The link will be in the description of this video. So let's choose create status as design and click on save. Now here again click on edit. And this is the section where you will put the filter. So previously it was only one filter, but now you can have three filters. So for example, permission set. If the user permission set belongs to, let's say, B2B buyer, I can choose another permission set, which can be, let's say, commerce admin. And I can choose another permission set, which can be, let's say, Einstein Analytics admin. Then what I can do, I can grant base if these permission sets are being already added to the user. I can grant another permission set, let's say, which is hello world, or I can remove permission set from that user and the Slack service user. So basically the enhancement is at this level. Previously it was only one filter criteria. Now you can have three filter criteria and all three can be permission set, group, profile, role, and all this thing. I think this is a very powerful feature and I'm happy that Salesforce is putting focus on that feature and making this feature more flexible. So previously they need to build flow or developers need to write triggers to grant or revoke permission set from a user based on some criteria. But with this tool, they can do the same thing in a declarative way. So I think this is a very powerful feature and we all should take advantage of that. So if you think this video is helpful, please hit the like icon, share with your colleagues, share with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, stay safe. Thank you. Bye-bye.